My name is Marieke van der Schaaf. I'm working at the Department of Education at Utrecht University. I'm the PC of the Watchman project, which is about workplace-based assessment with e-portfolios and student models.
I'm Bert Slof. I'm also working at the Department of Education at Utrecht University, also involved in the Watchman project, but I'm track leader of teacher education where the portfolio is developed and implemented.
In my view, there are more possibilities for monitoring and feedback for students. There are also more tools for learning analytics on the market and more availability of it. Also more use on mobile devices. So there is progress in the learning analytics side.
Yeah, I think that's one side of the story. And also I think it's more increased awareness because we now at medical education, teacher education and veterinary education with Watchman products, we're also making supervisors and students aware of what the possibilities are and also how it actually can be used. So I think that this is another side that is, I think, accomplished in the last couple of 3 years.
Yeah, a lot of people are working to connect the educational and technical sites and partners. So a lot is going on, but there's still a lot to be done, of course. Well, policy is very important, for instance, from an ethical perspective. Data protection laws and also how to bring the tools to the users, to teachers, and to make it available to students. And there are big differences between countries, also between institutes. So policy can be defined on different levels, and there are not very clear connections between the levels. So I think we have a world to win on the policy side.
I think it also has to do with the policy at the micro level, at the institution level, because if the policy is okay, we want to use learning analytics, there's also cultural things with the institutes that you have to think about in order to ethically make use about the possibility of learning analytics.
Yeah, actually it also has to do with culture. So it's not only policy, it's of course about strategy, having clear aims, what is learning analytics for, what kind of consequences should there be of the learning analytics. But it also has to do with the culture of users, especially some teachers, but also leaders in institutes are not that into ICT at the moment, or not yet. So they need skills, they need to be trained, they need to have positive experiences with it, and that will take some time. So it cannot be a top-down policy or top-down decision to use learning analytics. It's very important to use it from a bottom-up perspective.
Yeah, I think that's bottom-up and top-down. You also think about policies in how you want to develop and how you want to implement, because it's not only the legal and the ethical issues, but also how to develop, how to implement, because if you don't pay attention to that, yeah, I think it will be hard to realize the implementation of learning analytics in what form you want to do that.
Yeah, I think the best way to go is to have the users included in the design and developmental process. And that's what we clearly do within WatchMe. And you also see the hiccups, the difficulties, because the technical and educational partners, they have different languages, they use different words. Sometimes they mean the same, but they have another word for it. But that dialogue between the fields is so important. Without that, we cannot make the next step.
I think that also another step is also how to guide the interpretation. I think text messages are quite straightforward, but if you try to aggregate data into different kinds of types of visualizations, I think that's also a step that needs to be taken regarding policy, but also regarding development, how to interpret that in the same way. Because if you interpret the graph in a different way than I as a supervisor or a student does that, it's also becoming very complicated in order to provide the just in time improvement feedback or suggestion for broader types of improvement.
Yeah, and then there could be some misuse or negative consequences, negative impact, and that's really devastating for the learners, of course. So there's also something we should really care of, and that's the impact, especially probably negative impact on users. We should avoid that.
Yeah, and users might be students as well as supervisors. I think that's also a distinction.
Yeah. Actually, 5 to 10 years' time, that's not that far away. I think there's a lot of developmental work should be done. A lot of dialogue should occur. The use of kind of toolbox would be very useful for teachers, that there are toolbox, but also for schools and more institutional level. Toolbox, I mean, with learning analytics devices. availability to make it very easy to use it. For instance, based on an app, mobile devices. Students use mobile devices every day, so they can use their iPhone, for instance, with learning analytics applications to connect it to the teachers or something like that.
I think that there might be a distinction. 5 years technologically, a lot will be possible, but I think taking it in perspective, the 10 years will also be more the educational and implementation side of it. So I think that takes more and to implement it, to actually use it, and to also use it as a sports learning. I think that that will take more, because not only ethical issues, but also pedagogical issues. I think there are issues that need more time to resolve in order to make just a nice tool.
Especially to embed it in the curricula. That would take a hard time. Most curricula are already defined for 5 year periods or something, and there's a lot of negotiation when you want to change the curriculum at institutional level, and there are also national boards looking at the curriculum. So it's also a political process in the end, and that would take time, and I'm not sure whether we can do that in 5 to 10 years. From the technical side, I think there can be a lot of progression within 5 to 10 years' time. It's the human factor.